Hey everyone, this is Josh with a fun computer security tutorial for you today. In this video, we're going to be talking about another type of social engineering scam, the blackmail scam. What this type of scam looks like and how you can avoid falling victim to it. Email scams are very common. And one of the ways that hackers try to steal money from people is by tricking them into sending money through some type of threat. An email blackmail scam often starts by you receiving an email that looks like it actually came from your own email address. In this email, someone claims that they have gained full access to your devices, your phone or your laptop, using some type of malware. The attacker claims that they have access to all of your private information, your documents, your photos, your videos, your camera, your microphone, and that they have gathered some private dirt on you. What the scammer then says is that they will reveal this private or some type of embarrassing information about you to your family, your friends, your coworkers, anybody in your contacts list that they claim they have. But the scammer says if you pay them in cryptocurrency, instead of embarrassing you in public, they will simply delete the information and move on. This type of scam can be really scary if you're not expecting it or you don't understand how the scam works. Because nobody wants to be embarrassed, and nobody wants to believe that someone has gathered private information about them that they can sell or reveal to somebody that they don't want that information given to. But in actuality, the scammers are just using simple tricks and threats to trick you into paying them. One of the reasons that this scam is so effective is because there's a sort of simple issue with the email protocol that allows you to send an email to anyone and pretend it is from any other email address. In this type of scam, the scammers will put your own email in the from field in that email. So if your email address is x@y.com, they'll say that the email that they sent to you was from x@y.com. Anybody can change the from field of an email when sending it. In fact, that's how companies send you emails from an address like noreply@x.com. There's not an actual inbox somewhere they can receive replies to noreply@x.com. They're simply just putting that email address in the from field when they send out mass mailers. So scammers take advantage of most people not knowing this about the email protocol to trick you into thinking that they've gained access to your email account. But in reality, the only thing that they have access to is your email address, which is a pretty public piece of information for the most part. So they simply send you an email to your x@y email and include the same email address in the from field as well. Now, realizing this, you can understand that the scammer hasn't actually gained any information that is private. They're simply just using your public email. Another part of avoiding falling victim to this scam is simply just taking a step back, understanding the real risks, and thinking about what a real hacker would do if they had access to your full device. If somebody had access to all of your private information on a machine, your documents, your passwords, your accounts, your videos, they're probably not going to send you an email letting you know that you've been compromised and asking you for money. If somebody really had access to your laptop, they might simply access your bank account or a retirement account and try to steal money from you. Or if you're a cryptocurrency user, try to find seed phrases, private keys. There's a lot of things that somebody would do if they actually had access to your device that doesn't really make sense in this context. So understanding that you most likely haven't actually been compromised can help you avoid falling victim to this type of trick. All this scam involves is pressure tactics. It's another type of social engineering designed to scare you, and when people are scared, they do irrational things like pay scammers. It's important to note that these scammers do tend to use cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin because the transactions are irreversible. So if you are tricked into paying the scammer in Bitcoin and you later find out that this was a scam, there's no way to reverse that payment. They can simply keep the money. So it's always important to know when you are paying somebody in cryptocurrency for goods or services or any other reason, make sure that that recipient is legitimate before you send the money, because that transaction can't be reversed. So this is actually a fairly simple type of scam once you understand what's going on, despite how scary it can be when you get that email in your inbox threatening you unless you pay up. So if you're a computer user, learn how to spot these types of scams, warn other people in your network, and as always with social engineering, take the time to step back and think about what's happening before you act rashly. Social engineering, in other words, tricking human beings, is much easier in many cases than breaking systems. And so scammers love to use social engineering to get money out of people. As always, I hope you found this tutorial interesting and informative, and stay safe out there.